Welcome to Plyorotech YouTube channel. If you not subscribe, please subscribe Plyorotech YouTube channel, like, comments and share, and don't forget to click the bell icon. If you click the bell icon, you will get notification when I post new video. Okay, today I'm going to talk about airfoil section of the airplane. An aerofoil is any surface such as a wing or propeller that provides aerodynamic force when it interacts with the moving stream of air. Remember, an airplane's wings generate a lifting force only when air is in motion about it. Some of the terms used to describe the wing and the interaction of the airflow about it. This figure shows a cross section of a wing in straight and level flight. Chord and camber surface are which help to define the wing shape, while pile path and relative wind help define the movement of the wing with the respect to the surrounding air. Okay, let's see what is the airfoil section. If you see cross section of the wing of the airplane, you can see the shape. Shape is like this. This is called airfoil shape. This is the shape of the wings. Actually, not only the wings, propellers, aircraft itself, and most of the parts design like this shape. This is called airfoil shape. This upper and lower shape of the aerofoil is called camber. That is called camber. This is called camber. This is upper camber and lower camber. The camber of an aerofoil is the curved surface of its upper and lower surfaces. The part of the airfoil meet the airflow first is called leading edge. So this is the forward, most forward place is called leading edge. Airflow meet the leading edge and the airflow moving above the wing and lower the wing and meeting at the end of the point. This meeting point is called trailing edge. The trailing edge is the portion of the aerofoil where airflow over the upper surface rejoin the lower surface. This is the chord line. The chord line is an imaginary straight line drawn through an aerofoil from the leading edge to trailing edge. So this is called chord line. The surface above the chord line is called upper camber. This is upper camber. Upper camber. The surface below the chord line is called lower camber. That is called lower camber. So this is lower camber. So now you know about the chord line, upper camber, and below the chord line is lower camber. If the airplane is moving forward, that is called flight path of the airplane. Relative wind is the direction of the airflow with respect to the wing. Relative wind is the direction of the airflow with respect to the wing. If a wing moves forward horizontally, the relative wing moves backward horizontally. Relative wing is parallel to and opposite the flight path of the airplane. Airflow moving around the upper and lower camber. Airflow come and divide into two, moving upper and lower surface of the wing like this. So below the wing, moving like this also. So the airflow come and divide into two path and rejoining at the trailing edge. The distance of the upper camber is greater than lower camber. Now you can see distance of the upper camber is greater than distance of lower camber. This causes the velocity of the airflow immediately above the wing to be much higher than below the wing. As for the gas laws, if velocity increases, the pressure will decrease. Then airplane's wing generate a lifting force when airflow is moving around the wing like this, generating a lift force. But this lift always changes with the angle of attack of airfoil. So let's see what is the angle of attack. The angle of attack is the angle between the chord line of the aerofoil and the direction of the relative wind. Angle of attack is very important in the production of lift. This is chord line and this is relative air wind. So this angle is called angle of attack. This is the angle is called angle of attack. Okay, now you know already how to generate lift of the airplane and the aerofoil section. This is the airfoil shape and this is the leading edge. And this is the trailing edge. This is the chord line connecting with the leading edge and trailing edge. This is called upper camber above the chord line and below the chord line called lower camber. Chord line and angle between chord line and relative airflow is called angle of attack. The aircraft moving forward, the path is called flight path. If a wing moves forward horizontally, the relative wing moves backward horizontally. Always relative wing is parallel to and opposite the flight path of the airplane. You know already how generating lift by the wings, but all the aircraft generating lift because the aircraft body also designed as a aerofoil shape. Not only body, all the aircraft parts, propellers, elevators, all the parts designed as a aerofoil shape. So all the parts generating lift. So all the aircraft generating lift. But mainly wings are generating more lift. Okay, now you know already how lift generating and what is the airfoil section. If you are watching this video first time, please watch my previous videos, because this is a lesson is going step by step series. So you must watch the previous videos, then you will get the general knowledge of aeronautical engineering. Please subscribe channel, like and share and comments, and don't forget to click the bell icon. Thank you for watching. We'll meet in next video.